My kids grew up in a car very similar to this. We drove 500,000 kilometres around Australia in that car, and that's why I gave it to one of them, thinking they might value it, but no. Nah. So she's gone to God now, but this one looks exactly like her. G'day, I'm Cole Hayes. Next to me is my beautiful 1974 HQ station wagon. I bought one of these things when I was 20 years old, brand new in 1974. Cost me the grand total of $4,700. I had that car for 25 years. It was a 253 V8, 4.2 litre. After 25 years, I gave it to my youngest son, and within 2 years, it was sold to a wrecker. And I was cheesed off, for want of a better word. So a while ago I decided to relive my childhood and I would build a replica of what I had. And when this car is a November 1974 car, which was the last month they made HQs before changing over to the HJ cars. This one was orange, it was rusty, it had a brown interior with a bench seat, and it was pretty poor condition. So I stripped it right down to a bare shell. I got it painted up in chrome yellow, which was the colour of my original car. This one is a 202 six-cylinder. I was going to put a V8 in it, but my wife said, you're not 20 anymore, so you don't have to hoon around the place, so six cylinders will do you. I completely changed out the interior of the car to look like my old car. I took out the bench seat. I put black bucket seats in with houndstooth trim, black dash. So everything inside is all black now instead of brown. I got the wheels imported from the States, they're billet aluminium wheels, to make it look like the wheels I used to have on my old car. But now my wife's decided she doesn't like the bucket seats too much. So it's lucky I kept the frame from the old bench seat, because that's now in the upholsterers getting done in houndstooth like the interior of this car, and the buckets are gonna go. I've got a few cars at the moment. I'm the president of the local car club, the Gold Coast Antique Auto Club. I've got two cars in this garage you see behind me. I've got another two in that shed, plus a motorbike. Just about to get a Mini to restore, so I'm pretty tied up in cars. Being retired, it gives me plenty of time to do the work on them, and there's plenty of expertise within the club if I need some assistance. For example, I'd never pulled an engine down to the complete crankshaft before I did this one. And one of the fellas in the club gave me a hand and he was invaluable. And I learned so much about putting engines together. This is going to be in my family now for the rest of my life probably. It won't be given to one of my sons because I'm not a slow learner. They're not going to go through that again. My granddaughter's made noises about wanting the car, so once I pop my clogs, I guess I don't really care where it goes because I won't know. But for the meantime, I'm just going to enjoy driving. It's a lovely, lovely car to drive. I did have to put power steering on it because they're quite a heavy car to drive. Without power steering, my wife couldn't manage it, so I got some power steering. If anyone's got any factory air conditioning they want to get rid of, get in touch with me because I'd like to put some of that in it as well. But it's a beautiful area around here on the Gold Coast for our cars to drive around. We have plenty of shows at the club and runs everywhere every month, and these cars, as well as others, get lots of attention when they're put on display. It's my hobby. Costs a lot of money, and you get a lot of grief from the treasurer up in the house, but we get by. So I'm just going to keep doing it. I've had this car on a few displays. We recently had our show in China up at the clubhouse. They made, I think it was about 600,000 HQs in their day. I think it went from 1969 to 74. Lots of people come up and say, yeah, my dad had one of these cars, or this used to be our family car when I was a kid. And they have a look inside, crawl around it, and it brings back memories for them, as it does for me. It brings back my childhood memories. My kids grew up in a car very similar to this. We drove 500,000 kilometres around Australia in that car, and that's why I gave it to one of them, thinking they might value it, but no. So she's gone to God now, but this one looks exactly like her.